Okay, this is where things get slightly more interesting. Let's delve more into shapes because they're kind of smart. So we know we've dragged out a square here. In fact, let me just change the color of that because I'm getting bored of that one. And now let's drag out a circle. And the reason I'm doing this, by the way, is to show you that you can use the context toolbar to manipulate the initial shape. So I'll just go down and long press on this one here, and we get more options. I'm going to click on star tool, and I'm going to click and drag out a star. I'm going to hold shift so it stays in the correct dimensions, both sides. What else will I choose? Maybe the cog tool and one more. Let's go for the pie tool, because I want to show you something about that. Okay. Going back to the move tool, I'm on the move tool now. I'm going to zoom in so that we can have a look. So I'm just pinching with the trackpad inwards like that. Okay, so I've selected my square. Up here in the context toolbar, there is an option that says corner. And if we click on that, we can click on rounded. And you see what it does, it rounds off those pointy edges. And it also says 25% there, radius. So if I click on that, I drag up. All the way up, it turns into an actual full-on circle, just like the one on the right. And I can click all the way back and it will go back to how it was before with the pointy edges. So this context toolbar has allowed us to manipulate these shapes because they're kind of smart. Another thing I wanted to mention, if you don't like dragging these sliders around like this and you want a more visual edit, you can go ahead and click on the node tool. So you see this tool over here, the shortcut is A. If I click on this, you'll see now we have these little red dots on the corners. And basically these are the locations that we can edit because they're kind of smart shapes, right? So up here it says 24%. If I click and drag this, you'll see the percentage change. So I can just make my edits directly on this square. Okay, I'll just leave that there for now. And let's move on to the next one, the circle. What could you possibly do with a circle? Well, the context toolbar is telling me I can turn it into a donut in one click or a pie. So let's click donut. Once I've clicked that, I have many more options. Hole radius, let's play around with that. Start angle, and you know what? I don't know what the start angle is, so I will just go down and play around with the nodes, because I'm in the node tool, right? So I could just click on it like this, and let me click around with this one. Oh, okay, so that is the start angle. I do actually know, but you know what I mean. So I'm just kind of moving this around and it's giving me kind of these snapping points, like that's 90 degrees. And so I prefer to edit visually, so I'll play around with these. And now let me just press close pie and it will make it go back to before. I will just press Command Z to go back, okay? So Command Z, all the way until it goes back to being a circle again. Now I want to convert it to a pie. So I'm going to click on that and now we get our options. Because I'm still in the node tool, I can click on one of these and change the pie. Good for making pie charts or Pac-Man maybe. So that's what that's allowed us to do. And if I just zoom out real quick, remember over here I added a pie. These are all just kind of presets. Some of them can turn into other shapes as well, like the square turned into a circle, etc. So you choose the one that's right for you. I like these ones, okay, because you can add more points to it. So right now I can see this one, I can make it slightly fatter, and this one I can make those edges in the corner there quite round. And I can also click on this one and it kind of pulls it out. You see that guide? Pulls it out so it's almost like a flower. But what I can also do with this is I can go up to points and I can just drag this up to however many points I want. So there's 20 points there. And then I can start making my edits. So really cool. And you can also have inner circle look. That's the inside little dot there. So very cool. I'm not going to go through all of these, but here we go. There's a cog. You can play around with all of the red dots and make it as you wish. And obviously I'm not going to play around with this because you've just seen me turn a circle into that. So they're the shapes and there's plenty of options there. There's even a QR code tool. So play around with that and get creative.